COVID-19 guilt, a phenomenon associated with contracting the virus or passing it along to someone else.
News Center Maine's Hannah Dineen spoke with a mother about her emotional journey after her three children tested positive for the virus.
I was praying that it was just a cold or maybe just the flu. But when it came back positive, like, I think I just went white.
Terrified. That's how Nicole Cooley felt hearing her 8-year-old son tested positive for COVID-19, but not for the reason you might think.
The nurse practitioner in the room basically said, "Mom, it's going to be okay. He's going to be just fine." And I said, "I know he's going to be just fine. I'm concerned about the other people that we've interacted with."
Like many families, the Cooleys were keeping their circle tight, but the kids were still going to school and to dance classes.
It just becomes this overwhelming moment of like, oh my gosh, and then am I going to be ostracized because I'm the positive, right?
Fear of the stigma and fear of having passed the virus to loved ones.
Then to have to deliver the news to my mom that, by the way, we've had it, you've interacted with us, and I feel horrible. Like, I feel horrible because I don't know how your body is going to react to it.
I would say anxiety is just increasing across the board.
Dr. Christopher Muncie says these feelings of guilt associated with COVID-19 are common.
Some people have experienced feelings of guilt for having just contracted, you know, the illness. Somehow this feeling of their body has let them down.
Dr. Muncie says these feelings are largely irrational, but nevertheless all too real. Fortunately, Cooley's mother tested negative.
We cried and laughed and thank heavens that she was negative.
And her quick action alerting others limited the virus's spread.
For me, it was important to share with everybody that we had been in contact with in the last 14 days. Here's what we need to share with you. I am so sorry.
A difficult but essential call.
Don't be scared of what someone's going to say on the other line because you're just doing your job.
A job that hopefully stops the virus in its tracks. Hannah Dineen, News Center Maine.
And Cooley adds, from her family's experience with the virus, people should position themselves to be their own contact tracers. Keep tabs of everyone you and your family come into contact with. Also, have a plan in place for how you will get through at least 10 days of isolation if someone tests positive.